Now, you may not be the kind of person who likes to record in automation with a MIDI controller. Maybe you just want to draw in a pattern. And sometimes you can also be a bit more precise by drawing in patterns. So in this lesson, we're going to take a look at how to create automation clips directly in the software. And we'll also take a look at how we can further tweak it so it is exactly the way we want it.
Now, technically, what I recorded over here onto this clip and onto this clip over here is not really an automation clip. It's recorded into this pattern as MIDI CC data. Now we can choose to leave it as is, but we can also convert it to an automation clip. So let's see how we can do that. If I double click this clip, the piano roll editor opens. And at the bottom here, where we're looking at velocity, I can click on control here and I can switch to this pattern controls. Let's select this first one here. So this is that automation data I recorded, or in other words, the MIDI CC data that I recorded. I would now like to convert this to an automation clip. To do this, I'll click on this piano roll options dropdown, go to edit, and here we have an option called turn into automation clip. I'll select that, and now the automation clip window pops up. We have this convert to automation sensitivity option here. So if I increase the sensitivity, we get more nodes over here or little breakpoints to represent what I recorded in with the MIDI controller. But if I turn that all the way down to the lowest, we have the least amount of breakpoints, and we just have curves to kind of mimic what was happening over here. I like this, so I'm going to leave it at the least sensitivity and hit accept. All right, now if you notice in the playlist, we have a new track. It's already labeled body because that's the name of that parameter. And we don't have the automation clip here, but the automation clip is sitting on top of the original MIDI pattern. So let's just click and drag this downwards, and there we have it. This is the automation clip. Let's do the same for this pattern here. I'll double click. We're looking at velocity at the bottom here. Switch to the actual data that I recorded, and then click over here, go to edit, and select turn into automation clip. I'll set the sensitivity to the lowest, hit accept. Close out of here. We have that additional track, but we're not seeing the pattern, so I click and drag over here. And here is this automation clip. All right, now what if we don't have a MIDI controller and we want to create an automation clip to introduce that usual dynamic change in the sound? So let's see how we can do this. I'm going to add in an effect onto the drums track. So I've selected the drums track on the mixer here. On slot one, I'll choose an effect. Let's choose this one called Destructor. It has four different effects that are all active right now. I'll turn off the filter, the chorus, and the speaker emulation. Let's leave the distortion on. I'm going to change the distortion algorithm to a crusher algorithm. And now let's have a quick listen to what this sounds like. We can solo the drums. And now let's have a listen to this. So this introduces some digital distortion into the signal, and I would like to automate that. So let's right-click this parameter and select Create Automation Clip. All right, looks like nothing happened here, but if I close out of this window, close out of the mixer, in the playlist, we can see here we have that automation clip created. In this pattern picker, we have three options. The first one is for MIDI patterns. The second one is for audio. I don't have any audio clips over here. And this last one here is for automation clips. So you can see I have three automation clips in this project. Now here's my automation clip that I created for the drums, specifically for that crusher effect. And now let's edit this. I can click with this pencil tool to add a point. Now currently I'm in the step edit mode. So if I click and drag, you can see I'm adding a bunch of different steps. So I can create any kind of automation curve that I want like this. Let me undo that. If I turn off step, clicking on the line doesn't do anything, but if I right-click, it'll create a single breakpoint. And then I can grab that single breakpoint and move it wherever I want. I can curve the line in between the two breakpoints. If I right-click one of these breakpoints, I have different modes I can select. So currently it's set to single curve. Let's try the stairs option here. Now it looks like nothing changed and it just looks like a straight line over here, diagonal line. But if I click in this middle point and click and drag, you start to see those steps. Let's have a listen to what this will sound like. I'm going to solo the drums. Now I'll also have to solo the track that houses the automation pattern, otherwise it won't play back. Now let's have a listen to this. You can edit this while it's playing. I'm going to change some of these back to the single curve. Let's hear this with everything else. Looks like I've still soloed the drums in the mixer. Let's unsolo that. Alright, so that's how you can create offline automation clips and edit them to your heart's content.